8 teachers have received their profession's top honours for dedication and excellence. They received this year's President's Award for Teachers from President Halima Yacob at the Astana today. And she says that the recipients exemplify the saying, teaching is a calling.
As an educator, you do more than teach your subjects. Beyond a pursuit of excellence in academics, you also focus on the social, emotional, and mental resilience for our students and help to positively mold their habits, traits, and character. In this way, you help each student to grow holistically and achieve their fullest potential.
This year's awardees were selected from 17 finalists. They'll be able to take part in an overseas learning program to help them grow in their career. Two of them share their unique stories with CNA.
These cutted lines and boxes are not decorations in Madam Dawn Chan's classroom. The blue lines help to keep this class organized, while the yellow boxes provide those with special needs with the necessary structure to focus and remain engaged. This is just one way Madam Chan uses Universal Design Learning Guidelines to make her classroom an inclusive one. She has also modified her teaching methods to benefit the whole class.
They're all diverse learners, and they do have their strength in many, many different areas. So I use key principles of experience, concept, and application framework to guide myself in the various musical pedagogical approaches, whereby sound comes before sight.
That means her students first experience the music, then understand the concept, before trying it out on their own. And as technology transforms learning and education, Madam Chan also believes students are not the only ones learning.
Now to me, a growth mindset for teachers is important, as learning is always taking place and is essential because teaching methods are changing very frequently.
Another strong believer of experiential learning is Pauline Hu.
How many bones are there?
As a computational physics graduate, she encourages her students at ITE to think like scientists and be innovative when helping patients. The result? Assistive devices like this one, called sensor stove. It alerts elderly or their caregivers when the stove is on and unattended for too long. To Pauline, the best way to teach is to keep her students on their toes.
I think my methods are, it varies every day, so students were maybe caught by surprise. They will not be so boring. So I do frontal, I do games, and also I do a lot of drawings on the board. I do all kinds of things in order to capture their attention.
The IT whiz is on to another adventure. She's leading a team to experiment with virtual reality to teach and learn oxygen therapy.
I believe that every student, there's a hope. And I believe in everyone, for as long as they have a good attitude, you know, I'm willing to groom them, to help them.